Welcome home. I've missed you so much. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You're still sleeping. Get out of my life.
You arrogant, selfish bastard!
I'm leaving. I've got a new job.
Leaving. I never ever want to see you again!
I want you out of the house, out of my life.
Daddy, Mummy says you can come home now. I love him.
He doesn't love me. He never has.
In the next hour, it fell out of the air, but what caused disaster on Flight 182? We've reaction and comment here in the studio and from Ireland and Canada.
Is Joanna on the pill?
What makes you ask that? It's already salted.
Well, is she?
No, I don't think so. Not that contraception is the critical issue.
You don't know you're a mother.
You're her father.
Don't start.
Who's starting? I'm not starting, I'm just making a point. Can't I make a point?
But anyway, there's nothing to worry about. She is on the pill.
Are you going into college?
What?
Yes, it's my last day.
I'll need some help getting ready for Scotland.
Joanna? It's my first day off. Anyway, it won't be long. If you can just drop me at the station.
No, Joanna, your breakfast.
I won't be late.
The breakfast!
I'm off to
school. Oh, Susan! Susan, your breakfast!
Oh, down comes the roof.
Once a year when the sun comes out.
I wonder if anything else comes out.
Bye, Dad.
Give me a kiss.
Hey, Mark, can you do me a favour?
What?
I'm old enough to look after myself. You're only going to be gone 3 weeks. Dad, the thought of Scotland just drives me crazy.
Talk to your mother.
If I ask her, she'll just say no.
Well, you know as well as I do, she doesn't listen to me.
Please.
Look, I know this sounds like a cliché, and I've never discussed it with you before, but, boys.
Just because I don't want to go to Scotland doesn't mean I've got a boyfriend.
I didn't suggest for a minute that it did. Look. Men. Men are not to be trusted. Look, see what I've done to your mother. I mean, and I'm a nice man.
Please.
All right.
I love you, Dad.
I love you back.
I wish you didn't drink so much.
Shh.
Hiya.
How do?
Hi.
Another year over, thank God. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Hello, Delia. How's the thesis going?
Wouldn't believe how many new forms of cohabitation there are.
Really?
Everyone seems to be searching for an ongoing, intimate, personal relationship. It's a total obsession. Reaction against a mindless greed of Thatcherism.
You think they shouldn't be? You sociologists are all the same, feeding off other people's misfortunes. You think if you study something and you make a report that things will change, that there'll be progress. There's no such thing as progress, only insight. And for that, you don't need endless words, only silence.
Good God.
Exactly.
Does anybody want to hear about my study?
No. Who pulled his chain?
Oh, I don't know. Some wine?
No.
Are you all right, Dr. Pesco?
Yes.
You see the journal review of Charity's new book? It was brilliant.
You're lucky, more like. These days you can't get published unless you're black, crippled or female.
Barbara!
What kind of sociologist are you?
Unlike Charity, I just see what's in front of me. It doesn't mean I have to like it.
You're just jealous because Charity's achieved more in the 2 years since you left here than you have in your entire career.
Yes. It's only because she didn't have to look after a man, isn't it?
Who knows? Maybe a man is looking after her.
Surprise for you.
Thanks. What you got?
Listen, love, you've been on it now for about an hour and a half.
But the correlation. Cohabitation by height. Sexual orientation by foot size. What's this?
Max struck back. He's made a mess of the data.
Well, he'll have to put it right.
He's defected to another life.
What?
Given up the Bhagwan, gone to Bhutan. He's going to study horticulture.
Dear God.
Buy you a drink. You haven't been the same since Charity left.
What do you mean? You knew?
Of course.
Did everybody? Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, you should be pleased. Because since then, every female student reminds me of my daughters, and every woman over 30 either of my mother or my wife. Not you, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Maybe it's raised my consciousness. What do you think? Maybe you've created a new man of me.
It was more fun when you were a pain in the arse.
Mm.
I'm always around, you know. Even if it's just for a talk.
Thank you. Hello.
Mark, it's Delia.
Yeah.
Ivan's been arrested.
He's what? Look, I'm sorry, Mark, really. Could I buy you a drink?
It started with my father.
Ivan,
he
really?
Ran off with another woman when I was two. I suppose I grew up thinking I should prove that not all men were bad.
Ivan...
Shoplifting doesn't hurt anyone, you know. Shops get the losses back on the insurance and... it is funny.
Look, Ivan, as your professor, and bearing in mind your field, I can claim one bout of shoplifting as part of your research, but any more...
This is my fifth year.
Good God.
Look, something I've always wanted to ask you.
What?
What's it like?
For what?
What's it like sleeping?
Thank you. Well, I've only ever been with women.
That's
so.
What I mean.
Oh, I'm sorry. How old are you?
47.
And you've never?
Don't laugh, please.
I'm not laughing, Ivan. Well, it's a bit difficult, really. Some men would tell you that sex isn't worth it, but that's not true. To have a woman want you, and to feel her body, and even to control it is, well, but they're trouble. I mean, just when you think you've agreed terms, they change the game.
Charity wasn't like that.
What?
She really loved you. You shouldn't have hurt her, you know.
Oh, God. We might as well have carried placards.
Oh. Here's to a term of hard work. Congratulations, all of you.
And to your second book.
Yeah, well done.
And don't let your father spoil you in America.
Shelley's pregnant again.
Top of the pops!
I wish I knew what to do about Harry. Does he ever talk to you? Sure, you don't want to go to California.
Come on. I'm happy here, you know.
Yes, of course. Tom! It's a girl.
Susan, darling, turn it down just a little.
I'm going with her.
All right, Dad. Hey, you two, supper at 7.
Isn't it lovely, darling?
Yeah.
Oh, why don't you pop those two upstairs in the bedroom?
Slow down, for Christ's sake!
Tell. Mark.
Go back to sleep. Yes. Go back to sleep.
You don't talk to me. You don't let me touch you. I cook nice meals. I look after the girls. I do everything the best I can. I don't know what I'm doing wrong.
It's not you.
Do you want to go back to London?
Well, the girls would want to come. I can't.
They found friends. They'll be all right.
Well, if you don't mind, I could find out about trains.
Hello, yes. I'd like to send a telegram, please.
You had no right to send that telegram.
Yes.
Well,
I know I didn't. But there's some champagne. What's wrong? You look beautiful. Cheers. Decorated, have you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I thought you had. It's nice. It's lovely. I like all the,
So I take it you made the wrong decision.
What decision?
You went back to your wife.
You tried to bloody kill me.
Yes, I did, didn't I? Sorry about that.
Are you?
No, not really. So why are you here?
I miss you. And, Jane and I, strangers. And we don't sleep together or anything of that kind anymore.
So. Yeah, I've heard that before.
And if you loved me...
I do.
I promise that in the last 2 years or...
There's been nobody else.
There's been nobody else. And you?
No one.
I know that we'd always be lovers. We'd be fine, we'd be terrific, I'd be good. I'd iron my shirts. I wouldn't read over your shoulder.
So you can't move in?
We could see. You know, we could see. Can we just see?
I thought Dad was home.
Sorry. Hello. The key didn't seem to,
No. Well, I've changed the lock.
You changed the lock? I can't imagine what you think is going on.
Of course you can. We've lived together for 20 years. We both know exactly what's going on. It's charity, isn't it?
Look, lots of people have affairs. It doesn't mean anything. It's, you said you didn't mind.
I never said I didn't mind. I said I'd cope.
But I come back the last, 2 years here with you.
I never trapped you. You trapped yourself. Was I so bad?
No. Look, I'm sorry. Jane, I'm sorry. You have every right to be angry and whatever. But in a couple of weeks...
Now get out. Now. Your things are packed. Oh, and phone the girls. I'm sure they'll miss you.
You won't.
Oh, yes, probably. But it'll be a comfort to wake up in the morning and not feel a failure.
Well, where else could I go?
What do you reckon, Rachel?
It's okay, I suppose.
The NHS have finally agreed we can go on the IVF. It's a real coup. Just think, if a baby can live in a petri dish, maybe it can live in me. I mean, it's worth a try, isn't it?
I know the statistics aren't that good, but wouldn't it be wonderful?
Yes.
So what's the matter with you?
Nothing, why?
You're the picture of young love.
I'm old.
Not that old.
Ugh, I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't complain. For years I was desperate for him to move in, but... And Rachel's been really good too. But we don't talk. I do a lot of cooking. And sex, well... He seems so depressed. He's like James all over again. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm not supposed to live with a man. I don't know.
Don't be silly. And you talk to him. Look, it won't be you.
Well, that's all we've time for tonight. We'll be back again tomorrow at 10:50. Please join us once again then. Till then, from Jenny and me and all of us, a very good night to you.
Look, have I done something wrong?
What makes you think that?
You're so depressed all the time.
And it wouldn't have anything to do with you, would it?
I don't know.
Well, I mean, you care so much about people, you'd care about me, wouldn't you, if I said I was in love with someone else?
What? Are you?
No.
Then I don't understand.
I could have killed you when you had that affair.
What affair?
Don't give me that. In Evian.
Jesus Christ, that was 3 years ago. This isn't about that, is it?
I don't know. I don't always say what I feel.
But I didn't have an affair.
You expect me to believe that? Well, what was it then? A trick to get me to leave Jane?
I don't believe this. I did not have an affair. I chose not to. I don't suppose you can understand that. And believe me, I wanted to, and he wanted to, but I chose not to because I love you. And I love making love to you. And if I'd done it with anyone else, I couldn't do that properly anymore. And that's the big difference between us. Anyway, I don't think this is about that at all. I think you're just feeling guilty or ashamed, and that's why we can't go to bed properly anymore.
Don't be ridiculous!
What are you ashamed of? That Jane threw you out, or that you moved in here?
Jane was my wife! And to carry on an old relationship is not the same as starting a new one.
Jane threw you out!
Did she?
Yes! Oh, you're telling me that if you tried hard enough, you could have won her over?
Yeah.
Well, that's ridiculous. That's bullshit.
Do you want to know what's wrong with us? I'll tell you what's wrong with us. You!
Oh, great.
When I need you, you're working. You look a mess.
Yes, well, that comes with a job, I'm afraid. I am not Jane. You just want to be pampered and fed and watered all over again, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, you've come to the wrong house.
Yeah.
What's supposed to be in this deal for me? That's what I'd like to know. You can't even make love properly anymore! Oh, Ma. It's okay, really. It's all right. Raining?
No.
Sorry. I am sorry. I've been living alone too long. It's made me careless.
It's just as if we're a habit. Do you know? It's now. We're not special now.
But we can be still. We can be, and we must be. We've got to learn to be special and live together somehow. We can, you know. We can.
I really, really love you.
I really love you.
Yeah.
That's why I want to try, please. I don't want to fail again.
I really, really do.
Yeah. I do too.
I really, really do.
My hands felt wet.
Yeah. I'm really, really wet. Do you know?
Oh.
Miami.
Don't be silly.
Just forget it.
The whole issue is hugely complex, and we run the risk of discrediting birth control altogether.
On a friendly face with the rest of the media.
I'm sorry about the weather.
Slightest hospitality, Mr. Archer.
Already, but they won't tell me. I'm not your husband.
Excuse me.
Yes, Mrs. Walton.
Would you kindly tell Sister that Professor Carlton and I would like to see the doctor?
Certainly.
How do you like the flowers? The children asked me to bring them.
How are they?
Well, they're fine.
It's like we just met on a tube.
It's these places. I hate them.
I'm Emma Kennedy. What seems to be the problem?
Well, we'd like to know what's wrong with her.
Me?
Yes.
She has endometrial hyperplasia, and she hemorrhaged.
She? Me? I did. Did I? Why?
We don't know. But you're all right now, so there's no need to worry.
Thank you.
I think they know what they're doing.
Of course they know what they're doing. This is a teaching hospital. It's got an international reputation.
Yeah, for being underfunded.
Now, come on, you'll be fine. I've got to go. I've got a tutorial. Okay? Shall I leave you the paper?
Mavis said the proof had arrived.
Yeah.
Congratulations. When's it coming out?
Thank you very much. September.
Buy you a drink.
This one's on me.
Oh, it's lovely. Look what you've done.
It's Rachel who did it.
Oh, come here. It's just me hormones. I'll be all right in a few days.
Would you like a cup of tea?
Yeah.
Wonderful. I'm sorry.
There. It's all right.
I'm just so happy to be back. You're all so wonderful.
See all this? All right, well, I have to shoot. But I'll be back about 6, all right?
Okay.
why don't you come round and make things hard for yourself? Love arms.
Who is she?
Margaret Lacey.
Margaret Lacey. Margaret Lacey.
Well, I was drunk.
Margaret Lacey.
She seduced me.
Margaret Lacey.
I didn't mean anything.
Margaret Lacey.
You were in the hospital.
I was in hospital for 6 days. You couldn't handle 6 days. You just follow your prick, don't you? Like a nose without a bone in it.
I suppose none of this is your fault, no.
Oh, no, you don't. This is you! Monogamy is for grown-ups. What kind of wimp are you?
Well, will the government push ahead with their privatisation plans now they've been re-elected for a third term? 5 more years at Maggie? How do you feel about that? Phone me, Nick Carr, after this.
Hey, if we can solve any problem, why do we lose so many tears?
It's probably none of my business. But I wish you two would stop.
When the leading man appears.
I'm sorry. I mean it, really. I just don't know what I'd do without you.
I don't think I have any rights over Mark.
Of course you do, but I never intended to take him away.
Just borrowing him, were you? How'd you square that with your feminism?
Surely you did a little more than just borrow Mark from Jane.
For centuries, women have been taught to believe that they don't have a sexuality, that the only sexual drive that matters is the male's. We know this isn't true, so why should we pretend? I fancied Mark, I went to bed with him. It's what men are forgiven for daily.
I know what I did to Jane was horrible, but I did it for love. I did it for something that matters.
Well, you see, that's where you and I fundamentally differ. I just don't believe that true love between men and women is possible. Because no matter how many women men go to bed with, no matter how many or how few they say they love, male solidarity is always stronger than heterosexual love. It was only a couple of times. He never once thought of leaving you. Cling to that. Maybe it's the closest a man comes to love.
I'm not sure this whole thing's about feminism at all. Maybe it's just about the way human beings ought to behave to one another.
Perhaps. Men are half the human race. We can't change the old ones. But we must bring our sons up as feminists.
What is... You know why they write songs about Johannesburg? There's nothing in Cleethorpes to write about.
Oh, hello, okay. Hi.
This is Rosie. Rosie, my mum.
Hello, Mrs. Robson. It's great to meet you. I've heard loads about you and your family. I can't wait to meet them.
Rosie's from up north. But she wants to stay in London a couple of days.
That's all right.
I thought we could...
Well, you can put up a camp bed in Rachel's room, I suppose.
Can you help me off with this? I'm going to go get some plates.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, I don't know what to say. I mean, I don't want to sound like my mother, and I'm hardly one to speak, but... We've never really talked about AIDS and... I mean, are you careful?
Yes.
Do you wear condoms?
Yes!
I may not look like a great example, but Mark and I did know one another very well before... Well, before... Anyway, what about Joanna? Tom, I hope you don't treat sex like some sort of exercise. It's important. It can be... It should be the best expression of love that there is.
Just leave it, Mum. Right? Just leave it.
All right.
Come on, we're going.
What?
It's really good to meet you, Mrs. Walton.
Come on.
Oh, Rosie, I'm sorry.
Nice. What's the matter?
Stupid bitch.
Oh.
Well, here you are. There you are. That's yours. That's yours.
Thank you.
I don't actually approve of underage drinking, but anyway, but you could get yourself into real big trouble, the pair of you.
Dad, I'm nearly 18. Where are the crisps?
Sorry, I forgot the
crisps. Cheers.
Cheers. How are you?
Fine.
So, have you a man in your life at the moment? Or
no.
No. How's your mother?
She's fine. She's just started an open university course in English literature.
Yeah.
Okay, so you did it, didn't you?
Yeah.
Really?
You know how she loves books?
I know how she loves books.
She let me read one of her essays the other day. It was really good.
Was it?
Mm. Yeah, and this is really dishy guy that... Have you seen Blue Velvet?
Yes, but it's, ex-certificate. We walked out. We, left.
Yeah, I'm upstairs in Tom's room. Going through his laundry. Seems a bit like trying.
Well, after the girls, I'd rather stay in the dark.
Just didn't expect to feel so old.
Hang on.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, I'm on my way.
It won't be long. Just give me a minute. I'm going to get rid of this tea and I'll be right back. Yeah, Professor, you can't be in your office. Dr. Pastor, cup of tea.
Thank you.
Dad.
It's not possible. Not Pascoe, not embezzlement.
He has, admitted it.
How much money are we talking about?
£45,000. He claims refurbishings. Office equipment, a couple of CPT word processors, a Toyota space cruiser.
We haven't got one.
A new men's room.
A what?
A new lavatory.
I know.
Well, three of them, actually.
Where are all these things?
I'm afraid, Professor, in Pascoe's head.
Gambling, drugs or women?
It was love. How old is she? My wife.
I'm so sorry.
Things are better now. She still has to have the tranquilizers, but they've stopped the electric shock. I just wanted her to have somewhere nice to live. See, she doesn't like leaving the place.
Well, if only you'd said, perhaps we could have helped.
I didn't want to trouble anybody. But please, I must keep my job, you see. I'm too old to find another and then never be able to pay you back.
Who was that with you? Was that your daughter? Let me get her.
No! Please, no. I don't want her to see me like this. Please. I must have some time.
It's okay. It's okay.
Thursday.
Miss Pascoe.
Singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die.
I mean, my mother really is his life. You know, the department and my mother. I suppose it gives you faith in true love. You will help him, Professor Carlton, won't you? I mean, you will help him. He won't lose his job.
No. True.
Can you teach me how to dance real slow? Well, I know that you're in love with him, because I saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. Man, I dig those rhythm and blues. Come to me like a child who's lost his way. You make me laugh and make me cry with the words that you say. Will your love be around for a while, or be gone with the dawn? One day I'm gonna fly. And if I say I'm gonna fly.